When you're in sales, you need to make the most of every single conversation. But when you're just getting into it, you make tons of mistakes. You don't know what you don't know. So here are the 6 sales mistakes you should avoid at all costs. A great salesperson enters into the conversation confident, and they are there to help the prospect out. Your job is to build trust, to build credibility, and not try too hard to get the sale, because at the end of the day, you will succeed if your prospect succeeds. It's that simple. Help them out, and you will be helped out as well. If you're a professional salesperson, you know the pitfalls. You know that things come up that you can never expect. So let's jump into the 6 mistakes you shouldn't make. Number 1, not knowing enough about the client or their problem. They want to know how you can help them. And so having an understanding, doing research in advance, knowing the industry, knowing the problems or the common problems that your prospects will face, and doing research on the person you're sitting across from, whether it's a quick Google search or going to LinkedIn or trying to call up someone you know in common to find out a little bit about them, will take you so far. Let me tell you, it is insulting when someone sits down across from you and they haven't even taken the time, the courtesy, or have the respect to find out more about me. You are asking me for time, and then you won't even take the time to find out the basics about me? Of course I want to be helped, but if you won't even take the time to learn the basics about me, how are you going to help me through this really complex challenge or this problem? Or how can I even trust that you even know what you're talking about? Credibility and trust can be lost in a second. And so the better prepared you come knowing about them, the better you're going to be able to lead the conversation. Mistake 2, letting the customer drive the conversation. You know, if we know mirror and matching, we know that sometimes people are more passive and we want to be a little more passive. People a little A-type, we want to be a little bit more A-type. We want to be able to mirror and match the very characteristics, tone, and energy that the person has across from us. But when you sit down with someone who's calling all the shots, who has all the questions, and is making you dance and taking you off path and not even giving you an opportunity to respond to the last question before the next question comes up, you are in big trouble. So you have to be polite, you have to be considerate, you have to be thoughtful, but you have to take back control. The easiest way to do that is to reframe the question or the challenge coming to you. When someone questions you or challenges you, you don't want to sidestep it, but there's nothing wrong with saying, you know what, let me first ask you this because I think your answer will be answered if we have this conversation. You know what, I would love to be able to go away and come up with this plan, but I don't quite yet have all the information I need to be able to provide you something of true value. If other people are saying they can give you a proposal with the few details that they have, I don't mean to be rude, but they're gonna be lying to you. They're gonna make a whole bunch of assumptions on your behalf. They're gonna do this, they're gonna do that, right? And just honestly say, I would love to be in a position to help you, but I don't yet have this. There are tons of ways to take back control of the conversation if you do it politely and if you do it with their best interests in mind. But whatever you do, don't just allow them to steal the process from under you. 3, providing irrelevant information. And in sales, providing irrelevant information takes people off the path. It changes the way they think about you. Make some question, do you even know what you're talking about? Do you even know what's important to me? Why are you talking about this stuff? And we all make these mistakes. I can think back to when I first started, like go back to 2006. I'm sitting across from someone. I'm completely nervous. They say, what do you do? And I talk. Never ask them any questions. And then randomly I pull out of nowhere a customer testimonial, a written testimonial. I said, here's what people think about us. Totally the wrong time to do it. He wasn't questioning whether we needed a reference. He didn't even understand what I was talking about. And so when you're working with someone, the easiest thing you can do is ask them questions, because the more you ask, the more you come to learn, the more you can push through, the more you can guide the conversation. How do you know if they have interest? How do you know if they care? Ask them. What do you care about? I want to talk to you a little bit about this. Do you have any interest in talking about that? You know what? A lot of people in your situation are really looking for this and this. Is that something that you're looking for? There's nothing wrong with just asking what they value and what they're interested in and then having that conversation. It'll destroy you if you take someone off to some path that they literally do not care about. 4, trying to persuade the prospect. People buy when they're ready to buy, and they buy what they're interested in buying. You can educate them. You can help provide context. You can lead the horse to water, so to speak. But trying to get them to take action or pressuring them into something, trying to persuade them, people don't like that. People don't like to be sold to. They like to be helped. They like to know that you have their back. But they don't want you sitting across from them trying to sell them on something. Nobody likes that. So stop trying to persuade people, start trying to help them. And the best thing that I do is I put myself in their situation. If I'm speaking to a business owner, what would I do if I ran their business? Would I buy this product? Would I spend that money? Would I refer it to my mother? What would I do? And if I'm coming from that place and I still believe in it, I tell people that. For me, I would do this. I really would. I have this. I've done this. I would spend this. You don't want just the sale for today. You want the customer for life. So put yourself in their situation and you won't have to spend any time persuading them. Mistake number 5, trying to close the deal too early. Listen, what happens when you try to marry someone on the first date? They think you're crazy. What happens when you are on the second date and you tell someone you love them? You don't really know them very well. What is going on? That's what happens to you when you try to close a deal too early. People are ready to move really, really quick if they're A-type and if you understand them and they give you all of the buying signals to say, let's go. You can try a trial close. You can go ahead and say, is there anything that's keeping us from moving forward with this? You can try all of those kind of sales techniques. If they're ready to go, let's go. Don't drag it out. But the majority of people need to run something by someone. They need to feel good about it and they need a bit of time. And so if you build a sales system where you expect to close everyone at the same speed every single time, you will lose tons and tons of opportunities. Respect the fact that some people move slower and require a bit more time, patience, and care, and other people are willing to go right away. You got to adjust your approach based off of where your prospect is at. And mistake number 6, not scheduling the next step. Let's go back to the fact that no one likes to be sold to. I'm on a call with you and you're pressuring me for the next step. I'm the prospect. I'm gonna be a little slippery. I'm gonna be a little vague. I gotta go talk to someone. I gotta think about something. I'm not sure. But the truth is, it's your job to have a framework of what the next steps are. Let's set something up. Can we hold a time? We need to be able to speak. Because as a prospect, if I don't understand why these steps matter and what the next steps are, I'm into the wind, I'm gone. And so you need to explain all of those things. Here are the next steps, here's why they matter, here's what we need to do, here's what I'm gonna do, here's what you're gonna do, we're gonna come back together, how is next Thursday morning? We don't wanna take up too much time because the longer that this takes, actually the less momentum we're able to build internally. What's next, let's go. Because here's the thing, if they're not willing to give you the time, if they're not willing to meet with you, if they're being super vague, even when you're being a little more direct, there's a big red flag. I wouldn't let that meeting go. I would address it right there. If they're willing to give you the time, and then they cancel, and they cancel again, I would call that right there. There's a little red flag that's going off. But if they're willing to pull out their phone and book the next meeting because you made a point of it, and you are professional, and you're following up while the iron is hot, then there's a great indication that the person's willing to move through the process. People don't want to hurt your feelings. They don't want to be honest. They don't want to say they're shopping around. They don't want to say that they're getting a bunch of different quotes, that they're unsure. They're not giving you the real reasons. And there's nothing wrong with asking for the real reasons. Is this important for you right now? Or is this kind of more a long-term thing that we're thinking about? Do you have the budget even set aside? I just want to make sure because I got the impression that you wanted to move really quickly on this. We just spoke about all the ways that this is gonna help you, and I'm worried that you're gonna miss out on all these opportunities. If they're pushing back, if they're vague, if they're still not willing, you could try a few times and then let it go. But at least when you're walking into the meeting, you know exactly where you stand. Time is the enemy here. But whatever you do, do not leave the meeting or the conversation without clearly laying out the next steps, what you're gonna do or what they're gonna do, and when you are speaking next. Don't give them, I'll follow up with you next week. It's vague. Get a specific day you're gonna speak with them and then make it happen. So much of these 6 mistakes comes back to how you work, how you think, and your level of confidence. Don't try and sell on the first date. And like everything you do, the more you do this, the more micro wins you have, the more confidence you're gonna carry into the next meeting. Allow your wins to stack upon each other. Don't feel too bad about the micro losses and go out there and make it happen. Getting up at 4, barely sleeping, lots of coffee. That's the secret to success. If you want to up your sales game, be sure to check out this video. I think you're going to love it a lot. And I would appreciate it if you subscribe to my channel right now. Let's go.